Howdy folks, and welcome to Let's Play King's Bounty. This is a MS-DOS game developed and published by New World Computing and released in 1990. It also had, I think, a Commodore 64 and a Amiga port. I think there might have also been a console port for it. Maybe the Genesis? And this is one of Jon Van Caneghem's kind of brain children that led into the larger Might and Magic series. This is kind of like the precursor to Heroes of Might and Magic. So, the plot line is that basically we are one of these heroes. We are ordered by the king, I think named Maximus, and we have to find a scepter for him so that the forces of chaos can be fought off. And the way it works is essentially we amass a massive army and we wander the land killing everything in our way until we find the scepter. And to do so, we have to defeat villains and find treasures, and in doing so we find pieces of a map that tells us where to dig. So we have four classes here. We have, do I have a mouse cursor? Yes. We have the paladin, we have a knight, we have a barbarian, and we have a sorceress. They all have various mixtures of like usefulness in combat, like leadership, magic skill. And there's a third one that I can't actually remember, but we are going to be playing the sorceress. This is going to be Rovette. And we're just going to be playing on normal. As you can see here, the thing that's affected by the difficulty is you get a score multiplier and you have fewer days. This is not a particularly long game if you know what you're doing. And actually, as a sorcerer, we can kind of break the game a little bit. Oh, and we have, is there actual copy protection? Do I need the manual? Oh wow, we do need the manual. Okay, that's fine. I'll just let it boot again. We'll do this. Do this on normal. Do you wish to destroy the game of Rovette? Yes. New game is being created. Okay, 1 second. Jokes on this game. Oh, I actually have a copy of this in Meat Space. So, yeah, let's see here. I don't think it has an actual sheet. I think we're actually going to have to refer to the old manual. So let's see here, page 34. All right, line 10. Okay, and word 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is artifacts. And there we go. Welcome to King's Bounty. Oh boy. So, the way this works, we have us in the center. This is a town. This is King Maximus's court. We have our current villain up here, which we don't have one. We have siege engines right here, which we don't have any. I don't remember what this is. This tells us how many map pieces we have towards finding the scepter. And this is our money. So, first things first. We go to the king, and we audience with him. Trumpets announce your arrival with regal fanfare. King Maximus rises from his throne to greet you and proclaims, "My dear Rovette, I can aid you better after you've captured 3 more villains." Okay. So, let's see here. The F2 is controls. Do we have, I don't think we have mouse. Now it's C. There we go. I don't think we want sounds. Options gives us our controls here. Let's see what our army is. We have peasants and sprites. These guys all suck. So, information. How many? What class they are? How many hit points they have total? So 30 peasants with 30 hit points, they have 1 hit point each. Damage, 30 to 30, they do 1 damage each. Gold cost, which is like you have, I think, a weekly pay that you have to do, and that's what that is. Morale is normal. Different creatures have different types of morales, and if you mix them, they fuck with each other. So you generally want to stick to like one type of creature. Their movement, which is 1, so they can move 1 square on their turn in combat. Sprites can fly, which lets them move anywhere. And SL, I believe, is like strike range or something. Let me look. I have a manual. Except I don't want the manual, I want the convenient. Let's see here. Skill level. Okay. I honestly don't know what that means. I don't know what that affects. I don't know that the manual will be particularly useful here either. Because why would it be? No, it's too fuddy. We're just gonna go in here. So, in addition to this, we can also, if I can, here we go. Here is us, Rovette the Sorceress. We have a leadership of 60, and how leadership works in this game, if I recall correctly, is basically you can control that many hit points worth of a creature. So theoretically, we can have 30 more peasants. We make 3,000 gold pieces per week. We have 10,000 gold to our name. Spell power 2, maximum number of spells is 5. Spell power 2 is just like how good your spells are when you cast them. It's different, like has a different effect for every spell. The max number of spells we can have on us right now is 5. No villains, no artifacts, no garrisoned castles, no followers killed, and we have 0 score. Alright, so, can I move with O and on angles? Oh, it's wonderful. Numpad, you complete me. So, let's recruit soldiers. So you can see here, we can get militia, archers, and pikemen. So we'll get some militia. Max of 30. Sure, so they probably have, if I had to guess, 2 hit points each. God, what is it? A, there we go. Yeah, so you can see they've got 60 hit points. They're twice as good as our peasants. Why not? Let's go ahead and get some archers because they have ranged attacks. And some pikemen because they're kind of beefy. We have 5,000 gold pieces to our name. I'm not going to get siege weapons because we don't need them yet. We will, but not yet. I am going to buy a bridge spell. I'm going to get us a contract, which is our first villain, Murray the Miser. He has no alias. He's worth 5,000 gold. He was last seen on Continentia, which is where we are. And he's in an unknown castle. Distinguishing features. He has threadbare clothes, bald patch with hair combed to cover it, and an incessant cough. His crimes. He's wanted for various petty crimes as well as for treason. He allowed a group of pirates to enter the castle and free criminals. Alright. So, we got that spell. This is treasure right here. So you can see, after scouring the area, you fall upon a hidden treasure cache. You may take the gold, distribute the gold to your peasants, and by doing so, you increase your leadership by 2. Generally speaking, that is what you want to do. So that is what we're going to do. At this point in the game, leadership is very, very important. And, yeah, we do have sounds on. There should be, like, little bloops and stuff. I'm not particularly worried that there aren't because the sounds in this game are really annoying, and I'd probably disable them anyways, but there are normally sound effects. So let's go ahead and cast that bridge spell. Let's build it here. I can't get down there. We need another one. I should have built it here. I thought it was only one square, alas. So yeah, let's grab another bridge spell. They're cheap. Why not? No, what's it? U, A, over there. There we go. And there you go. Another 2 leadership. So let's come over this way. And there should be, yep, some skeletons. Ooh, ghosts. No, we're not gonna fight that group. That group is, I think, beyond us. They won't follow us back here, thankfully. This is kind of like the safe place. At least in the early game. Orcs, sprites, peasants. Okay. So, this is combat. So our peasants can move 1. So they move 1 and that's all they do. So sprites can move 1 or they can fly. You hit F, you pick where you want to go. And I'm going to actually fly them next to the enemy archers here. Because in doing so, the enemy archers cannot attack us. And I'm going to have the sprites actually attack their... yeah, their archers. Didn't kill any, and you can see that the archers retaliate. Which is wild and sucks. So it is our archer's turn. We're going to have them shoot. We're going to have them shoot their elves, or their sprites rather, and we're going to move the pikemen probably about here. So there, as I say, they're going to kill our sprites. Their sprites are going to fly to our archers, because that's what they do. Oh, but they attacked our pikemen and paid sorely for it. Okay, so peasants move there, militia move there. Archers move here and shoot, kill the peasants. Pikemen kill those. Okay. So yeah, these orcs are in trouble now, yeah. Those militia are gonna make short work of them. There we go. And this should kill these guys. There we go. So we've killed them. We got 325 gold pieces. And welcome to King's Bounty. This is the majority of the game. No. We're gonna come down this way, because I want loot. Distribute to the peasants. What do we got here? Sprites. We can recruit 68 at 15 gold pieces. I'm gonna take all of them, because, yeah, we're gonna have to fight this. Ogres are pretty beefy. The rest of these enemies don't worry me at all, but those ogres can be pretty damn nasty. So we're going to start whittling them down a little bit. Ogres, like, our militia have 2 hit points, right? Ogres each have 40. So, yeah, our pikemen have 10 comparatively. So we're basically going to just have to kill them by numbers. The thing with ogres is that they're beefy as fuck, but they don't necessarily deal a lot of damage. That's kind of how a lot of the hills monsters are, is that they just have, like, sacks of hit points. But when it comes to killing, they're not great. Those skeletons are gonna chew on our, on our sprites. It's okay, sprites retaliated. Sometimes it's better to have a lot of things than only a few really strong things. I accidentally moved my damn archers like a fool. Hey, there's an ogre down. Where's the zombie going? That's probably going for my archers. It's okay, I can have them pull back next turn. Peasants, just go there. Militia, yeah. Laying waste to everything. So one thing is, you can see up here it says S11. That means that they have 11 more shots. Anything that has projectile weapons in this game has limited shots with them, I believe. I don't think there's anything. Like, we can later on, there are, like, I think you can get druids, and they can, like, throw lightning bolts and stuff. Alright, got those little fellas back. It's the King's Treasure Garden. We really, I think, only lost our sprites there. What do we have here? Orc skeletons. Oh, yeah, another easy fight. We will have our archers shoot. Skeletons have 3 hit points, zombies have 5. And archers do 1-3 damage on a shot. So they're doing, 6-18? So, we might kill a couple orcs, and of course they rolled shit for damage, so they didn't. And we are going, our sprites are, like, at this point, they're basically there to harass. And they're doing really, really good at it. Because orcs, like, they can shoot fewer times than archers can, but they deal much more damage. Our peasants up, militia are going to kill those things. And we're going to go ahead and shoot this guy. So this game, by the way, I believe is abandonware. So you can just go online and grab a copy if you want to play it. You're just going to have to figure out the manual on your own. But it also, in recent years, has spawned a new game, Many Sprites. We'll try it. It has spawned a new, like, series of King's Bounty games. And they are, like, this game, if you know what you're doing, you can get through this game in, like, a couple hours. I expect this Let's Play to be fairly short. But the new ones, they're like 30 hours. They are big games. Oh, that was a poor choice, enemy sprites. Okay, we're gonna move our peasants here. Get our militia up there. Start whittling down these skeletons, I guess. There we go. Trying to think. I'm gonna just move my sprites. I want that thing to close with us, because that way we can just completely surround it. Okay, and we're just gonna fly the sprites over here and have them going. There is no facing in this or anything. There's no flanking that you have to worry about. It's all just some straightforward combat. It's a good game. I enjoy it a lot. This is one that I'll play through a couple times a year. But I will admit the start of it can be kind of slow. Let's see here. We will distribute it to the peasants. How are we looking? Our leadership is up to 70. By the time we finish this game, our leadership will be, like, in the thousands, if I had to guess. Being a virtuous maiden from the clutches of a despicable criminal, you have been granted the title, or we have been granted the Articles of Nobility and a piece of a map to the Stolen Scepter. So the Articles of Nobility are one of the artifacts, and that will have done something. You can see that our commission per week is now 5,000 gold pieces. So that is what the Article of Nobility did. Each artifact does different things. Like, there will be one that increases our, like, spells per day, one that increases our I think there's one that actually doubles our leadership, which is just absurdly powerful. Okay, so those guys are there. We're gonna fly the sprites, have them murder those. Skeletons aren't gonna be able to do a whole heck of a lot, because there's only 2 of them. I mean, they're gonna kill sprites, but The zombies aren't going to be able to do anything because they can only move one. Militia are in melee. I should have probably... Eh, nah, we can get the peasants in if need be. Okay, and we're actually going to have the sprites come down here and start working down the zombies. Because they'd already retaliated and they'd be able to kill them off. So there we go. And it looks like we have another group up here. Oh, a few skeletons flee in terror at the sight of our vast army. So that's to kind of encourage you to actually, you know, at least try to engage enemies. There are also a chance that, like, when you bump into a group on the map like that, they'll actually offer to join you. The astrologers proclaim the week of the dwarves. All dwarven dwellings are repopulated. So yeah, the way it works is that, like, when you hire units from areas, like this sprite dwelling over here, there are a limited number in there. You can see there are 100 in here. And that will not refill until we hit a week of the sprites. So there are a finite amount of every unit in this game except for the ones you get from King Maximus. He has infinite soldiers for your use. And we're gonna blow all of our money on additional soldiers. His guys are expensive, though. Rent a boat. I would like a boat. Like, a boat will let us get into stuff. But I think I'd rather... God, those ghosts fucking terrify me. Dwarves are also tough. Ghosts are nasty because anything that a ghost kills comes back as another ghost. So yeah, I think what we're gonna do, we're gonna rent a boat and putter around a little bit. Because like you can see here, you've captured a mischievous imp which has been terrorizing the region. In exchange for its release, we receive a teleport spell and more leadership. Okay. We can recruit peasants, 10 each. Sure. See, in a fight with ghosts, peasants are terrible because the ghosts will destroy the shit out of them. And then each peasant goes from being something that does one hit point and deals one damage to something that has 10 hit points and deals, God, what is it? It goes, does 3 to 4 damage. So substantially nastier. See a freeze spell. Eh, I'm actually gonna buy siege weapons while we're here. More peasants, don't care. So do we have dwarves, orc, skeleton? Sure, we'll fight this one. Dwarves like ogres. Dwarves are essentially weaker ogres. I think it's probably a good way to explain it. Like, ogres are a tier above dwarves in the hierarchy of the plains. They also move slow, so he's not going to be able to attack us. Okay, peasants. Get him in there. But yeah, you can see, like, they're beefy boys. But he has retaliated, which means that the rest of us can chew on him with a little fear. Oof, 11 damage, ouch. I would like to get my peasants in there, because what peasants make up for in being utter shit, their damage is static. It's going to deal 76 damage, which, like, a group of peasants, like, those peasants would have fucked that stack of dwarves up. Like, we would have been killing 3 dwarves per attack with our peasants there. So what do we have here? Murray the Miser, hey! And his army. Ooh, I wish I knew what his army was. See, what is our army? I don't know if I want to go in there with peasants, that's the thing. I mean, let's try it. Lay siege. Oh, he's just got a bunch of peasants. And wolves. Wolves are a challenge. Okay, so I'm gonna move this here. Wolves are fast. They, I think, have 3 movement, perhaps. Yes, they have 3 movement. So the wolves will be able to close. So I'm gonna actually move this dude back, and we're gonna arrow some of these guys. The peasants are gonna fucking fuck our shit up, sadly. Fly my sprites here and kill this stack. Wow, didn't even kill the stack of peasants. That is incredibly disheartening. Oof. And there go my sprites. I don't know why the militia moved over there instead of rushing down, but I'll take it. Okay, so those peasants... I'm gonna sacrifice my militia, I think. To kind of whittle that stack down. Because peasants in small-sized stacks really aren't a threat. Like, as you can see, it's the bigger ones that are very dangerous. And that stack of militia over there kind of worries me. But I'm actually going to have my peasants get into it with them. Yeah. So I think we're going to be okay here. But this is going to be kind of a fight of attrition. God, the damage is so bad. There we go. The pikemen are pretty nasty. But the rest of, like, the castle units are... they're very middling. They don't really have any strengths. Like, it tends to be that, like, we just have a lot of them that we can throw at things if need be. Well done, Rovet. You have successfully vanquished yet another foe. We get 1,550 gold for the capture of Murray the Miser, and for fulfilling the contract, we receive an additional 5,000 as bounty, and a piece of the map to the Sceptre. Alright, so we have a castle here. I'm not gonna garrison anybody there, and we are gonna whistle our way back to town. Because we got money now, and I'm afraid of everything. Let's go ahead and grab these peasants. Why not? Week of the Ghosts. Mostly just excited that I got paid. Alright, and we are going to recruit soldiers. Blowing all of our money. No archers. They all survived. No pikemen. They all survived. And I believe we need two more. So who is our next contract? Hack the Rogue. Elias the Spitter. Reward 6,000 gold pieces. Last seen on Continentia. Castle Unknown. He has a bushy, even beard stained with tobacco juice, numerous battle scars. He's brash and has arrogant behavior. Along with many minor infractions, he's wanted for conspiracy against the crown and grave robbing. Well, that's just wonderful. I do think, however, we're going to go ahead and call it here, and I will see you guys next time when we can begin hunting Hack the Rogue. Until then.